Hi guys, Steve here from SMS Fitness PT. Just going to do another quick video for you just to show you a way to regress your press ups. Especially you ladies, you find press ups very difficult. Obviously not quite so much muscle mass there. Doesn't come quite so naturally to do a press up. So there are ways to regress your press ups and make them easier for yourself. Now, I really don't like the whole put your knees on the floor thing when you find press ups difficult. Because if you keep doing that and you always do that, you're never really going to get an awful lot better at doing press ups, to be perfectly honest. Okay. You'll be able to build your endurance a little bit, but you're never going to be taking your full body weight, and that's going to keep you weak, basically. Okay, so don't like press-ups on the knees. A lot of people also don't find them very comfortable if you've got knees, knobbly knees, etc. You know, that might just hurt, might not be very comfortable, so that's not always a great option. I prefer to elevate your hands. Okay, so when you're doing your press-ups, the higher up you do them, the less difficult that press up is, but you'll still be able to maintain a nice straight body position, and you'll still be able to gradually build a full press up and just keep angling yourself down every time you do that. So if the ground's too difficult, don't give up straight away and go to the highest possible option. Just work your way up slowly. So what I've got here is just a step, okay, and assuming you haven't got any wrist flexibility issues, as discussed in one of the previous videos, you'll be able to just put your body weight up on the step and do a full press up from slightly higher up, and that's going to be a lot less difficult than it is on the ground. Okay, so I'm up here, still got your good posture, still want to make sure that your shoulders over your wrists, and when you drop, your chest's going to touch the box. You still want to make sure your position's good. Okay, but that is easier by far than press ups on the ground. So essentially, all you want to do is you want to find a level that you're able to do. Set yourself a certain amount of reps, maybe, that you want to be able to achieve. If you want to be able to do 50 press-ups, start off doing 50 press-ups on the wall, just standing upright, and then work your way down to gradual levels, okay? So this is what I mean by that. I'll show you the wall and a couple of slight regressions underneath that, right? Okay, so press-ups against the wall. The issues you have with these, as always, really, is just a wrist flexibility thing. Because of the angle that we're coming at, we need to create a little bit of distance in order to press ourselves against the wall, but of course that then changes our natural angle. So I want to be here, fingers touching, but I can't, I have to go palms flat as well. That makes it a little bit uncomfortable, but okay, you can then press yourself into the wall. And you can do as many reps as you like. I've done this with clients before, just getting started, and it's still hard work for them. So that could be enough for you if you're just getting started and that's all you need. Just do it like that, okay, and then gradually put yourself down, as I say. The only issue you've got here with this one really is obviously your head. You can't go quite as deep as you want into the movement without ending up with your head in a funny opposition, alright? So what you don't want to do is look off to the side or look up, because that just throws your structure out, okay, just throws the muscle structure out. And ultimately you're going to end up building yourself in balances and so on and so forth over time. So try not to do that, but that's a good place to start if you're very, very weak in that area, and then you can build up from there. So you can also do it gradually coming down. Sometimes I do it with people on a barbell, and sometimes I do it on a bench. So I'll show those as well, just to give you an idea. Okay, so the principle of a press up is the same, whatever level you're doing on, okay? You still want to maintain a nice, solid, straight leg into back position, okay? Still want to end up with your chest touching or coming as close to whatever surface you're doing the press ups on. So this is just another progression really from doing the press ups on the wall. I do these always on my tiptoes as well, just to give myself a decent angle, drive my chest up to the level that I want it. You can still do press ups from that angle, whatever rep range you're looking for. That's perfectly comfortable to hold on to as well. Alright? Okay, so bring it down once more. Same situation. Okay, hands on a bench. I usually put my thumbs over the back of the bench so I don't slip off, just in case. Okay. Same position with the hands, a little bit wider than shoulder width. Get to the bench. Back up again. Alright? That's all there is to it, guys. Just keep moving your press ups from a high position. Just keep getting lower and lower and lower at your angle. More acute your angle is, the more difficult your press up is going to be. There's loads of further ways to progress your press up from there. But first, just concentrate on trying to get a do it on the ground, okay? Just go through everybody, okay, guys and girls. You might not be able to do press ups to start with, you might not be able to do very many press ups, maybe you want to build that up. And sometimes the best way to do that is to progress it slightly, put your reps up quite a lot, and then over time you'll be better and better at doing them on the ground as well. Alright, thanks for watching guys, hope this has been of some use. Speak to you soon.